Good evening, everybody. Thank you for watching this final live stream of my Midsummer Tour. Some of the biggest adventures in my life have been out on the road, touring around. It's not just the travel, the places that you see, it's the people that you meet and the things that happen along the way. Now, tonight I'm inside my studio on Shoreham Beach in Sussex, and this is where I spent most of lockdown recording music for my new album, Wheeled Barrows. And this album should have been released in the Cathedral on Orkney on June the 4th, at the very beginning of what was to be my Midsummer Tour, a tour undertaken on bicycle that would have taken me from Orkney all the way to Santiago de Compostela. The section of the Midsummer Tour would have ended tonight in Clayton Church, Clayton Village, nestling under the downs, not far from where I live. And that's a gig that I played last year as well. It was the final gig of my 2019 summer tour. And it was absolutely packed. It was a really, really special night. The Reverend Alex Baxter hosting, and my lovely friend Michael Danks, who's a wonderful, creative person, great cameraman as well, actually. He was helping me with the lights. So, Reverend Alex, Michael, thank you for organising tonight's gig. Very sad that none of the gigs happened in the end. The whole tour has been rescheduled for next year, and my promise was to do a live stream on every single night by way of a kind of proxy gig. So it's a proxy gig tonight. I'd much rather be with you lot in person. But Reverend Alex has very kindly sent through some film. So we're gonna roll the film in just a moment. And then I'll be back with a live recording of a lovely piece of music. So over to you, Rev.
Hello, this is the Reverend Alex Baxter from the parish of Clayton with Kema. Welcome to St John the Baptist Church. This time last year, Richard played what is known in the trade as a blinder, a fantastic concert here at St John the Baptist. The church was full. It was just packed, it was great, and Richard played a lovely set, really, really interesting music, everything from Terega to Bach, and obviously a lot of his own compositions as well, so absolutely brilliant. Sadly, this year there isn't going to be a concert, but I hope you can join us online, and Richard will be performing as if he was here in this church that is over 1,000 years old. So do please try and support Richard and all other performing artists as they struggle to make a living in these very difficult times. And although things are slowly coming back to normal, it's going to be a while yet before we can have proper public gatherings. So do please join us and to support Richard Durrant and to listen to his wonderful music. And he's going to be booked for the 27th of June next year, 2021, to come to this church and fill it once again with people and with music. This church is 1,000 years old, and Richard, when he was here, played the concert with using his bogoak guitar, which I believe has wood in it that is over 5,000 years old. So if you think Christ is, it's 2,000 years since Christ walked the earth, Richard's guitar is 3,000 years older than that, which is something to behold. And to hear it played in this beautiful pre-Reformation church was a real joy. So do come and support Richard on his online concerts, support our parish, and come and hear music once again in this church as soon as we are able to. Thank you very much. I wish you well, and God bless you and all your families. Thank you.
Thank you, the good Reverend Alex. Lovely to see you there inside the church. We found a picture taken last year during my warm-up in the church when I was playing. During the gig last year, I played a Bach cello suite on this beautiful little ukulele. Lovely little thing. So, and that was part of the plan this year, was also to play lots of unaccompanied Bach. But I will be back next year. The date of the Clayton concert next year is the 27th of June. I really hope that venues will begin to open as we come out of lockdown, but proceed with caution, we have so little information in this country about what's actually going on. We're at a bit of a disadvantage, so please do make sure that you support your local venues, your local churches, and if you want to show support for the work of musicians like me, then check out their websites. I have a single coming out next Friday. It's a sort of an eco song. It's called Kenneth the Hedge, and it's my single release ahead of the new album that's coming out. So check that out as well. That's you can download that or stream that, or even write into Six Music and say, play Kenneth the Hedge by Richard Durrant. You can also go on my website. All the dates for next summer are already up online. Now, the last piece of music is a South American piece. I thought it would be very appropriate for all sorts of reasons to include this piece. It is effectively a musical prayer, Una Limosna por el Amor de Dios, an alm for the love of God, by Agustin Barrios. It's also known as La Última Canción because it was the final piece that Barrios wrote just days before he died. It's a beautiful, beautiful piece. And this film is interesting. It's made by myself and a good friend, Peter Lisney, with whom I run my online academy, richarddurrantacademy.com. And the film is a live recording, but it's filmed in this very room, with these black drapes and all the lights and cameras and goodness knows what. So these are great fun to make, these films. You have to do a lot of practice. So I hope you enjoy this. And thank you, those of you that have been watching all these broadcasts. I will be back. I'll be streaming live my Sunday guitar meditations every Sunday at 12 o'clock. I think Clayton Church, of course, should now be open. So you can go in and you can see that beautiful building. And if you want a bit of peace and calm, a bit of contemplation, then go and visit the church and stay in touch. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoy this piece of music. Goodbye.